Are your orchid leaves browning and yellowing at the tips and you're not sure why? Let's have a look into it, one of the possible causes and how to fix it. Welcome to the Nature Company. If this is the kind of information you're interested in, please hit that subscribe button down below if you haven't already and that notification bell to be notified of all our upcoming content so you don't miss out on a thing. So we're looking into why the tips of your orchid leaves start to brown, they get these yellow markings on them, and it just doesn't look very attractive. Often you'll find it happens at a specific time of year, and you're just wondering, what could this be? Well, anthracnose is a very probable cause. It will generally attack from the tips of your leaf and work its way down, and that's what gives you these brown dead markings at the ends and these yellow halos as they arc their way down along the leaf. So what is anthracnose? Anthracnose is a group of fungi that cause this sort of disease in your orchids. They generally start off with these like brownish colored spots, generally relatively shiny. Also, you'll notice there is some shine where this yellowing is happening and this dying off. It's almost as if it's got a gloss to it. Anthracnose is one of those fungal diseases that particularly likes your soft-leafed orchids. So things like your phalaenopsis, your oncidiums, your stanhopias, your masdevallias, cymbidiums, phlogenes, all of those with those nice soft thin leaves that can be damaged relatively easily, especially due to sun or to the cold, and that's when they like to get in. These brown spots may start anywhere on the leaf, and then as they expand and grow, they'll form these blackened spots in the center, and these will eventually die off and dry out as dry parts of the leaf, and then eventually this will fall off, and you'll end up with a hole in the leaf with a ring around it, and like a black dark brown ring, and as the fungus spreads it will have that sort of yellow halo around it as it spreads out further and further down the leaf. This generally doesn't attack the new growing points, it attacks leaves that are generally feeling a bit under the weather, whether it's from sun stress or cold stress or physical damage, mechanical damage, and then it will work its way down the leaf, and that might then get to that growing point or those new leaf growths, and that may prematurely kill your plant. Generally, it's more of an unsightly disease than a deadly one if you are treating it or catching it early. Also, the one thing about anthracnose is it's not spread from the roots upwards into the plant, which generally makes it a little bit more easy to treat, as contact fungicides actually will probably do the trick quite well with this. And then as the fungus spreads its way down the leaf, it can almost give this like watery mushiness to it before it dries out to the dead part of the leaf. So that's what actually gives it more of that shine or that glow that seems to appear. This is just the cells disintegrating and dying. It's a sad, sad thing. And the reason that you might land up with the appearance of anthracnose on your orchids is a couple of reasons. Generally, they like that high humidity with that almost stagnant air. This allows them to spread really quickly, and that's what they're looking for, to be able to attach themselves to those leaves, especially those damaged or stressed leaves that are more susceptible to their attacks, and that's where they'll start off. But once they're in the plant, then they can spread down through all that fresh, strong growth and even into those growing tips, like I said. So what you're going to have to do is ensure that you've got good ventilation, and early morning watering is probably the best to allow for those leaves time to dry off so that they're not kept moist or wet all the time. Those extended periods of dampness is what's going to also help the fungal spores germinating and infecting your plant. Also, you've got to be aware of what can bring this disease into your orchids. Sadly, it's brought in by a lot of those perennials, especially daisies. So if you've got daisies in around your orchids and you're having problems with browning leaf tips, rather move those daisies away. They are carriers of the anthracnose causing fungi, and if you don't take them away, it's going to cause constant reinfection. Also, other common perennials, and weeds. Weeds are big carriers of the disease, so keep your area free of weeds and you'll have less of a problem with reinfestation of anthracnose. And when going through your preventative measures, if you're using preventative fungicides or biological methods to help prevent fungus, a good idea is to add some seaweed extract fertilizer into your mix when you're spraying the fungicide. This helps break down the surface tension of the water, which allows for better contact of the fungicide to the leaf of the orchid, which will help with the absorption of that fungicide into the plant and also help with contact of the fungicide onto the fungus itself in the fungal areas. And when catching this, as soon as you start noticing it, what you need to do is take nice sanitized equipment, cut off the damaged infected parts and destroy it so that it can't reinfect. Those freshly cut wounds, seal them with something like cinnamon to help prevent further infection of any fungus along those damaged wounds. In your efforts to ensure that you don't get any anthracnose attacking your plants in the first place, avoid overhead watering, avoid excessive watering, try water at points early enough to allow the plant's leaves to dry off. Ensure that there's good air circulation. Air circulation is an important part in the prevention of this disease because, as I've said earlier, you may find it attacking your plants periodically, and this is generally during those high humidity, wet times of year, and then other years as it dries out, they seem to disappear. So if you're able to keep your leaves in a drier state, they're less likely to be attacked by anthracnose causing fungi. And one of the ways that it is spread the most is by that overhead watering and those splashing of those water droplets from one leaf onto the others, and that's how the fungal spores are often spread to your entire collection. So if you can avoid that at all, it's probably best. And then when finding any signs of infection, isolation. Removal of the infected parts of the plant and isolation and treatment. This is just to avoid any further inoculum reaching the rest of your orchids. And then of course, preventative measures. These need to be taken at the times of year when you find that anthracnose is going to be most prevalent in your area. Often, again, when there's high humidity and when there's lots of water around. So in a lot of areas, this is your mid-spring to late summer time periods for a lot of areas. And with anthracnose being primarily a leaf-affecting fungus, although as it grows and spreads down your plant, it will then get into your pseudobulbs and then slowly kill off your entire plant. There are times with certain orchids, like the odontoglossums particularly, where you may get the fungal spots happening on the pseudobulbs themselves. But anthracnose itself is primarily a leaf spot. It's known as anthracnose from the Greek words anthrax and nosos, meaning charcoal, or in other words black, and nosos is disease, called black disease, because of these spots that it causes on the plant and the blackening and dying of the leaves. And one of the reasons that a lot of people think that this is just possibly caused by a lack of water or something like that is because anthracnose likes to attack those orchids which are under some sort of stress. So it could actually be root stress that it's under, whether the roots are dying or they're rotted or something like that. And then the opportune infection will take place and cause this browning of the leaf tips. But it may not necessarily be because of the root damage. It's the fact that the plant is under stress and the anthracnose has managed to find its way in. Be aware of this and that you don't then think, my roots, it's under water stress, it needs water, to then start overwatering, because then you can cause this disease to progress a lot faster. So if you know what you're looking out for with these almost layers of different colors as the disease progresses down the leaf, with this halo at the front end as it extends down towards your plant, no, rather treat it with a fungicide that's going to be effective for anthracnose instead of just thinking it's a water problem. Talking about the treatments, most fungicides will work, but they have found that anthracnose causing fungi are more sensitive to benomyl and bitethanol than the most of the others. That doesn't mean you must then go use these four anthracnose every time you find it, because then you'll start breeding resistant fungi again. Remember to keep those rotation of your fungicides. It's extremely important. It's important not only for you, but everyone else in the plant world too. So remember, the signs you need to look out for anthracnose infections are those browning leaf tips in varying shades as they move up with a yellow halo moving forward down the leaf. You're looking for blackened brownish spots that may be irregular or circular in nature, or have that dark ring around them with a lighter center, which is dying out and going papery thin and leaving holes in your orchids. And also the understanding that anthracnose is very much a seasonal disease and can seem like it has completely disappeared during those drier months, but it's easily brought back by just about anything. So keep your plant in good health, keep good air movement around it, don't allow water to be sitting on your leaves constantly, and any stressed plants will generally be the first ones to get it. So if you do notice it, other than treating it, check to see what the reasons of the stress for your plant are, and it will help you diagnose other deeper problems in your orchid as well. And if you need any specialized individual help for your orchids, please hit us up on that Buy Me a Coffee link down below. We have a dedicated line for that and look forward to hearing from you. Thank you for watching. If you have found any of this information helpful, please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button down below, and that notification bell, bing bong, to be notified of all our upcoming content so you don't miss out on a thing.